Hyped with a little Breaking Benjamin. Ben knows that song good and well. We all know he does. For those of you who don't know, classic Diary of Jane right there. Well, it's time for our weekly matchup preview. Last week, woo boy, took around the old poop shoot there thanks to some Sunday shitouts and a whole week shitout by the original champ right here. So I can't blame anybody but myself on that one. But past 2 days, tried to recoup. Whoop. For those losses, with hopefully adding some stud pitching, and while departing with a couple pitchers or a couple offensive players that I hopefully don't need down the road, gotta hope for some health for the original champ, or I could be SOL. If we look back at last week, Ben and I, if you read the weekly Cup of Joe that he published this morning, he went 6-0 this week, while I really sucked it hard, honestly. I went 2-4. Hence why today's Scherzy, represented by J.R. Smith, lay the pipe. Well, just like the Cavs last night, I got the pipe laid right up in me. So that's why we're rocking some Cavs. Unfortunately, couldn't take them down. But LeBron and crew will be back next week, so slide a little basketball into our baseball shindig show. Not much else to add right now. A couple trades have transpired in the past day or two. Those that don't know, Thrill Will, the original champ, departed with everyone's favorite Brave Dansby, or excuse me, everyone's favorite non-Freddie Freeman Brave Dansby for could be a risky Tanaka pickup, and just completed an all-day talks trade session with Jaycock, where he finally culminated in a little Christian Yelich and Chris Sale action for Nomar Mazara, Lance Lynn, and Jake the Snake Arrieta. So we'll see how those moves pan out for the two squads involved. I'm hoping they pan out better for me than my ERA did last week. Solid 5.29. No one really likes that. All right, so enough about me. Let's move into last week and the matchups. And, excuse me, not last week. Let's move forward. We're done backwards. B Green, champs in at 6-1 real quick. Let's all take a moment and take that in. B Green, 6-1, leading the league. Not a division. Not a division. A league. While one league, all four members sit at 3-4 or worse. So this is a topsy-turvy league, but still competitive all the way around, no matter what Ben says in his Monday morning mashup review, which I gotta say is, unless your last name is Harbor, he's straight crushing folks. I mean, you just wake up and you're like, damn, what is Ben gonna say about me that is painful? But you know, with Ben, he's just gonna be a dick because he's Bedell. So we've all come to agree that love him. He's a dick and I'm just an ass. It's, you know, it's how we roll. All right, let's hit it forward. Let's go into the future instead of back in the past. We are not, Michael J. Fox, and we are not going back to the future. First up, that's a Harbor matchup. Let's go ahead and just get that one out of the way now. Let's dump on Wacky Deli and Belch Huggins for a second. I picked Belch Huggins to win. I'm going to pick against Wacky Deli for a while. He's going to be a dick. I'm going to be a dick right back. That's how we can do it. He did say he picked me to win this week, so I'm not going to pick you, Ben. Sorry. I still don't have a lot of faith in your squad. I'm going with Belch. He's trying to make the stealthy moves, picking up Joe Ross today. I saw that stealthy son of a bitch. But I can't disagree with you, man. Joe Ross is going to be a solid pickup. So, Belch, I'm predicting you are going to take down the W this week against Wacky Deli. I almost forgot to say it like that. So, good kudos to you, Belch. You're going to get your division to 4-4 at least this week, so somebody will be sitting at 500. God, it's like looking at the late, early 2000s Eastern Conference, if you will, right now we got right there. Or maybe last year's AFC South. Not last year's. That's when the Falcons straight crushed it. 2 years ago, whenever I was 7-9 or worse. All right, moving on. I'm picking up a little Jobu, who's been struggling, versus Master of Puppets, who's also been struggling. Both teams coming off two-game losing streaks. Both teams doing all they can, still staying active. Once again, Flash, another team, unlike Ben says, mid-season quitter. I see Flash posting on the message board. I see him getting on the smack talk. He even talked about soccer the other night. I'm going to go ahead and tell you again, Flash, we are America. This is America. No soccer. We play football. F-O-O-T, not F-U-T. So, but Flash, I'm predicting you lose this week. I don't think Jobu's offense is going to let him down again. It kind of let him down last week. He didn't crack up 265 total bases. So, Master of Puppets, I still like your base squad. Still like Trout, Arenado. But we'll see what transpires here. I just don't see Jobu going down for 3 weeks in a row, which is sad because he's in my division. Moving on. Let's look at a little, oh, God. MH. Who the hell is MH? You know, I put abbreviations down for these teams, and I sometimes forget them when I'm rocking through it. But Maverick Hunters, clearly MH versus Powerless Gloves. Been on a bit of a slide ever since he started talking shit. And it must be because he doesn't know shit about sports right now. His message board talk is killing me. All right? So that's why this week's drink, that's why this week's sponsorship, brought to you by Gatorade, not Bama Aid. Not Tide Aid. That'd be like shit water. It's brought to you by Gatorade. All right? Real men drink that. Real athletes drink that. And that's why Power Gloves, I predict you to lose. Your college football talk has gone to your brain. College sports talk in general has just blown your brains out your head. It's straight mind-boggling. And I think Mavericks Hunter is... Anthony, you're the fucking shit right now, bro. I can pass the bar to you. You're fucking doing work, and ain't nothing wrong with that. You're the other team Ben's giving some love to right now, so it's some Harbors and a black guy. There you go. Moving on. And David Justice for All versus Man Bear Pig. David Justice for All didn't make a trade like Ben stated, and he picked up a W. Whether those two events coincide with one another, that's really neither here nor there. I can't really say. But what I can say is I expect his winning ways to continue one more week. I like to see Man Bear Pig lose. Not because his name is horrible. I straight love that name. Al Gore would appreciate it. I just, you know, I like seeing teams in my division go down for defeat. Makes my competition take down. I can relax a little bit and just kind of coast. Kick, push, kick, push, kick, push, and coast. A little Lupe Fiasco for you right there. So, and David, Justice for All, you're going to pick up a dub this week. Just go ahead, check it off right now. You can pretend that you are now 3-5 or 2-6 or whatever your record's going to be. All right, so now I'm moving into my, some might call this the pick
7.
Bingo!
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 Bingo! I've got a bingo!
I've got a bingo with this pick right here because I'm expecting... Nothing else matters to defeat Disabled List here. Seems like a cinch, no-brainer pick. So we're going to call that my B-I-N-G-O. Bingo, bitch. Pick of the week. Last but not least, because it's involving thrills, involving the original champ. Original champ versus Dr. Larry. Dr. Larry, I spied your numbers from last week. That's what I expected all friggin' year long. Killer batting average, great pitching, total base annihilation. I'm not lying. I'm a little bit worried. I'm a little bit worried this week. Mom Harb used to have my number. I defeated her a couple times last year to kind of get my groove back, but I have myself circled. I'm still going to go with me. Dr. Larry, you're the best moms in the league, but I got to say, I'm going to beat you this week just for old time's sake. So, just to recap, we got me pulling out a dub. Belch pulling out a dub. Jobu pulling out a dub. Nothing else matters. Pulling out a dub. We've got Maverick Hunters and David Justice for All pulling up dubs this week. I don't know what else to say about that. It just it seems like it's gonna be a good week. We see some trades going along out there right now. So aside from that, we're just gonna keep on motoring. We're gonna watch some basketball tonight. We're gonna watch this Warriors sweep Benson like Spurs right out of the playoffs. Sad for Benjamin, but it's Warriors and Cavs, and that's all we really want to see. So I'll leave you with a little.
Just forgotten what the color of her eyes were, and her scars or how she got them. As the telling signs of age rain down, a single tear is dropping through the valleys of an aging face that this world has forgotten.
We out. Till next time, guys, leave some commentary. I want to hear what you think. We need more than 10 views. That means not everybody's watching the video. Rise against. I'm rising against Dr. Larry. There is no reconciliation. Shit. Wrong button.